Hey guys, welcome to yet another vlog of 7 Creations. This video is specifically for Honda WRV owners who are really fed up with their Digipad 1.0 systems and are looking for a good replacement option which is available in the aftermarket, which is a modern system and also low in budget, can support steering mount controls, the reverse camera, etc., everything. So let's get started. So Honda WRV, first generation. It's a fantastic car and people really love to drive it. The build quality is awesome, everything is good, but there is only one major problem in the Honda WRV, both petrol and diesel top models, and that is the Digipad 1.0. It's a quite outdated music system which doesn't support either of Apple CarPlay or Android Auto, which means it is no more than just a Bluetooth player. And that too, something which is very, very laggy. It hangs up in between while you're driving, which is another bad thing. And there are a lot more problems to it. A lot of customers have already taken this complaint to the highest levels of Honda, but still all in vain, which means nothing has happened. Honda has released a Digipad 2.0 version, but that is given to only the Honda facelift versions, which came sometime by the beginning of 2019 or the end of 2018. As you can see, I'm sitting in my Honda WRV, which is a diesel top model. I purchased this car in the month of March in 2018, which means I also have Digipad 1.0 installed in my car. And like many other customers of Honda WRV who own the same car, I was also facing those issues which they have faced. In fact, my Digipad 1.0 was even replaced in warranty once, but I was not given Digipad 2 as a replacement. All I got was again the same problematic Digipad 1.0. The only difference was that it was a new player given to me. So after doing a lot of research in the market and the internet, I finally found a good solution for me, and that is a Megasonic Android based unit which I got installed from one of the shop owners in Karol Bagh in New Delhi. This is a Megasonic Android head unit which comes with 4GB of RAM and 32GB of internal memory. It's an Android player in itself, which means it can act as an individual tablet like you have in your homes. You just need to provide it a hotspot connection so that it can connect to internet and can act as a full-fledged working tablet. It can support all your favorite Android applications like Google Maps, Gaana.com, Amazon Music, etc. You can even install YouTube on it and play a video. The only thing that you need to provide is a mobile hotspot connection so that it can connect to the internet. It has a GPS module also built in, so it can detect your location by connecting with the satellite. This unit runs on Android version 10.0, and as I mentioned, it can work as an individual Android tablet fitted in your car, having its own GPS module. It has a built-in microphone which you can use to either provide voice commands or even take phone calls when you connect your mobile phone via Bluetooth to this system. Now, my personal favorite thing in this Megasonic system, for which I actually purchased this system, is Apple CarPlay. It supports Apple CarPlay both wired and wireless, which is a very good thing. And since I am an iPhone person myself, so having Apple CarPlay in my car was on top priority for me. To run Apple CarPlay, you have to either connect your phone using the wire to the front USB socket, or you have to connect your phone via Bluetooth to this system. And then there is an application, you just click that application, it opens up and it starts Apple CarPlay for you. Once Apple CarPlay application starts, you get that beautiful looking iOS GUI on your system itself. All the apps that Apple CarPlay supports will display on the system, and you can control them using the touchscreen only. You don't have to do anything on your phone. So with Apple CarPlay, you get two navigation options. First one is everybody's favorite, Google Maps, and the second one is Apple Maps. Other than that, you get the music applications like Wink Music, Gaana.com, Amazon Music, and many other applications which are supported by Apple CarPlay. It's more like operating your cell phone from car's infotainment system. Now coming to the wiring part, I understand that a lot of people are really concerned that they do not want any wire cuts in case they are going for an aftermarket solution. And I think in that case also, this music system made me really happy, because to fit this system, we did not have to cut any wire to get it working. It was all coupler to coupler, end to end. And it was very cleanly and nicely fitted by the shop owners. Now coming to one of the most important questions that a lot of people have asked me, is that what works and what doesn't. So I'll start with steering mount controls. And once again, I'm really happy to mention that all the steering mount controls work flawlessly The volume up down button, the previous and next track button, they all work like a charm. I can answer the calls using my steering mount controls, and I can even end the calls. There's only one thing in steering mount controls that doesn't work, and that is I cannot redial the last number using the call button. I don't know if it is a general issue with Apple CarPlay or is it an issue with this system only, but I am not able to redial the last dial number, which was not a deal breaker for me, so I just went ahead with it. Now coming to the USB ports, so the one which is on the front, that is working, but the one that is inside the armrest, that's not working. Another important thing is the reverse camera. The reverse camera works perfectly, however, I'm not able to change the angles of that reverse camera. I've spoken to the shop owner and they said they have a solution for it. There is some setting that needs to be done in the Android player, and there is an observation that since it is a 9 inches model compared to our 7 inches DigiPad 1.0, so the reverse view that I see is a little bit distorted on the edges. This is because you're projecting a smaller angle on a wider screen. I think once I get to sort out the multiple viewing angles of the reverse camera, I'll be able to get away with this issue also. But at least for now, the widest angle of the reverse camera is working perfectly fine for me. So now coming to the pricing part, so this whole system with fitting, etc., everything, it costed me around 15,000 rupees, and I think it's really hard to find a system today which supports Apple CarPlay at such a reasonable price. And this system comes with a 1-year warranty also. If there is anything that goes wrong in this system, I won't have to go to the company or the service center. All I need is just go to that shop owner and he'll take care of everything. I'll leave contact name and number of the shop owner in description below, so that if you're looking for a modern aftermarket replacement for your Honda WR-V DigiPad 1.0, you can call them and you can get it installed in your car as well. I hope you like this video. If you found this video informational, do give it a thumbs up. If you're new to the channel, do consider subscribing. Thanks for watching. This is Gaurav signing off. See you in my next video. Till then, goodbye, take care.